Good afternoon. Welcome to a very special day for our USC Upstate Women's Basketball Program and our Spartan Armory family at large as we formally introduce our new head women's basketball coach. A couple of housekeeping items. After the press conference, we will have an opportunity for our media to do sidebar interviews with Coach Williams. Those can happen either right here or inside the Hodge Arena. And we encourage you to meet Coach Williams immediately following this as well. He'll have an opportunity to do a meet and greet right here as soon as his remarks are over. I was going to have a wireless microphone be able to take questions from the crowd as well. If I'm standing over there, hopefully that will work better than it just is right now. We'd like to welcome some of our other head coaches that are with us today. Head men's soccer coach Scott Halkett, our head volleyball coach Rhonda Shirley, men's basketball coach Dave Dickerson joining us as well, and Jake Subak, our new director of sports performance. Until today, our head women's soccer coach Sharif Saper was our newest member of the head coaching team here. He is out recruiting today, and that is something Coach Williams might be doing even as this event is happening today. Head softball coach Chris Hawkins, baseball coach Mike McGuire, our cross-country and track and field coach Carson Blackwalder, and our men's and women's golf coach Todd Lawton are all in various stages of practice at the present time. I certainly want you, we welcome you to this special event, and for those of you watching on our YouTube channel as well. Without further ado, please welcome our Vice Chancellor and Director of Athletics, Daniel Fine.
Thank you, Lenny. Okay. Truly honored to be here today with you to formally welcome our brand new head women's basketball coach, Jason Williams. Super excited for you to be here as our 16th coach in our women's basketball history and our third in the D1 era. Thank all of you for coming today as well, in particular Dr. Harris, members of our leadership team, our cabinet, members of the faculty and staff, and our coaches and staff. Couldn't be more excited to have you here to celebrate this special moment with us. I'm so excited to introduce Coach Williams today and tell you a little bit more about him, but also want to tell you a little bit more about the process that we've been through for the last couple weeks. It's been a rigorous process, a really busy process, but an exciting process. Before I get to that, I want to thank a few special people. I'd be remiss if I didn't thank Coach Becky Burke, Coach Ambrose, Coach Wheeler and Coach Landers for everything they've done for our program for the last 2 years to help elevate us to the next level, put us in a position where we can compete on a year in and year out basis for conference championships and NCAA berths. So I'm so excited there. I'm really excited and thankful here to have Dr. Harris here as well. When the job opened up, it's the first call I made, and was really thankful to have his support through the process to support us, our vision for what we were looking for as a coach, and let us really run a true national search to make sure we got the right coach for USC Upstate at this time. And so thank you, Dr. Harris, for your support. And last but not least, I want to thank our search committee. They put in countless hours to help us get through this process in a short amount of time. In particular, I want to thank our Associate Athletic Director and Senior Women Administrator, Sarah Gildersleeve. Associate Athletic Director for Development, Scott Nikovic. And our head men's basketball coach, Dave Dickerson. They put in tens of hours vetting candidates and helping us come through and gave each one of them had so much expertise to offer, and I really appreciate their support. So I will tell you, a head coaching search is a whirlwind. It is not for the faint of heart. It is a busy, busy process, just like you see on TV with other institutions. You may recall this position opened up on Wednesday, April 6th. We put out a press release about 4 p.m. By 5 p.m., I probably had five or six text messages and emails with applications and candidates submitting their interest. By the time I went home, I had about a dozen that night. And so it immediately kicked off. In the end, we had somewhere in the neighborhood of 75 to 100 folks express interest and formal interest over about the course of a week. Sarah and I came in that weekend and fielded dozens and dozens of calls, called a lot of colleagues, mentors, friends around the country to ask who was out there, but also to try to listen a little bit of, you know, what are the strengths of our position. There was all this extraordinary interest in the position and literally dozens and dozens of calls. And so I will tell you, my phone battery is not nearly as good as I thought it was. It ran out immediately and over, but it was a fun process. I will tell you, every AD has a list for who they are looking, you know, a list kind of in your back pocket in terms of the position opens, you know, what you might be looking for. But I'll tell you, in this instance, we had so many great candidates, dozens of sitting head coaches, dozens of assistant coaches, Power 5, down to Division 1, 2, and 3, NAI, junior college, you name it. Everybody was interested. With all that interest, I would try to determine what exactly are we looking for, right? So we talked a little bit to our staff, a little bit to Coach Harris, to try to figure out what are the keys to this position? What would help make us successful in the future? As an athletic director, I'll tell you, this is the hardest part of my job in terms of the most important decision I can make is who to surround our student athletes with. This person will have such an impact on their 4 years of college, but more importantly, the rest of their life. And so there's nothing that I take more sacred in our position, so you really, really want to make sure we got it right. So what were we looking for with that in mind after having a lot of conversations? A proven winner, right? Somebody that can win. Somebody that ideally has been a head coach and shown that they can win on the court. Somebody that is an authentic, genuine person. Somebody that can build relationships, who can show student athletes how to become not just great basketball players, but great people in life. Somebody with a great recruiting ability. Somebody that knows our region. These are all strengths. And of course, somebody with some high energy, that's fun, enthusiastic, wants to be here. And of course, somebody with integrity and character. And most importantly, somebody that can help build a culture around our program of success, accountability, trust, and love, among others. And last but not least, somebody who has a proven track record promoting academic success. We want a team that performs just as well in the classroom as they do on the court. We also want somebody who's proven they can succeed at any level, and they can succeed sometimes with stretching resources, right? We're a mid-major, and we want to make sure we can be successful with what we have. So the other group I talked to were our student athletes. Asked them, what do we need to be successful? And true to form, they basically repeated what I just told you. They want somebody who has proven success, but they really want somebody who is willing to build a relationship with them and get to know them on a personal basis, that will know something about them, that will learn about their lives, where they've come from, and what their vision is for the future as people. So listening to all that input, we started interviewing, right? A lot of phone calls, Zoom interviews, and ultimately some campus interviews. And I'll tell you, Coach Williams immediately set himself apart from the pack. On his first phone call, he passionately advocated in text message, several text messages, for this position. And when you get to know him, you'll see he's not an arrogant person, but he has a quiet confidence. He knows how to build a program of success. He advocated in that way, but he's done it. He's done it in our region. His resume proves it. And more importantly, he's a true leader of young women. When you hear from him today, I want you to listen. He'll talk to you a little about the pillars of his program, and I think they emphasize what kind of person he is and what kind of vision he has for the long-term nature of our program. His five pillars that he values are, for his student athletes, integrity, humility, selflessness, belief, and growth. I think you'll hear him repeat a little bit of that when he talks a little bit today about who he is and his vision for the program. And I think it also talks a little bit about, explains who he is as a person when you realize he's a licensed professional counselor. In my years at four other institutions, I've never worked with a head coach who's a licensed counselor, and I think that's really special and important. It tells you a little bit about who he is and how he goes about building relationships with students. So now that we got all that out of the way, what else are we looking for? Well, I want somebody who can win. somebody that has a proven track record of winning on the court. So it really kind of dug into Coach Williams' background. When you dig in, it's interesting to learn about a person. He was a student athlete at Greensboro College in North Carolina, where he was captain of this basketball team. And then he got out of college and started his career as a coach at Belmont Abbey as a men's assistant coach for 8 years. He's an extraordinarily loyal person and had success on the men's side, but ultimately decided after a while, maybe he'd give coaching women a try. And so he went down to Jacksonville State University in Alabama for a year as a women's assistant coach before being called back to Belmont Abbey to be the head coach, where he's been for 9 years. In those 9 years, he's been Conference Coach of the Year 4 times. They ought to just name the award after you. I'll talk to the commissioner, see if I can get that done. The last 5 years, he's won 2 regular season conference championships, a conference tournament championship, and he went to the NCAA Elite Eight 2 years ago. He's been an extraordinarily successful coach, but again, as you'll hear, he's even a better person off the court. So I couldn't be more excited today to introduce you to our next head women's basketball coach, Jason Williams.
Stand in front of you today as the next head coach of USC Upstate women's basketball. that faith has allowed me to be able to be here in front of you today as a young man that's going to be able to lead women for a duration, long after they have come through the doors and walked and gotten their degree. The faith has put me there. Secondly, I want to be able to thank Belmont Abbey College, Stephen Miss, Dr. Thierfelder, Dr. Travis Fiesel, for the opportunity to be at an institution for 16 years, to be at an institution that has shaped me and molded me to the individual I am today, to be able to guide individuals on a regular basis. And their hand in who I am today has allowed me to be successful. And so I gotta be able to say thank you very much, Dr. Thierfelder, Dr. Travis Fiesel, and for Stephen Miss in general for giving me a chance. Coach Miss in general 10 years ago gave me the shot to be a head women's basketball coach when nobody else would. And so I thank you for all that you've done for me. In the gratitude portion of this one, I gotta be able to thank my friends and my family. They have sacrificed a lot to be able to allow me to be able to do this job really, really, really well. The opportunity to be able to spend countless hours in the gym, to be able to go out there and recruit consistently, to be on the phone constantly and be engaged both in and out of the household. And so I've got to be able to thank my friends and my family for all their attention, on all their love and all their sacrifice that they have done to be able to help me be on this stage today. And I got to be able to say a special thanks to Dr. Harris, to Daniel and the search committee in general for this opportunity to be the next head coach here. This is a great, tremendous opportunity. As soon as I walked on campus here today, during the interview, I knew the people here were special, right? The quote that I always say consistently is, rising tide rises all ships. And it starts with the people at this institution, and they care about the kids that they are servicing on a regular basis. And I want to be a part of that institution and a part of those people that are doing those things. It's not just the women's basketball program, it's all of us moving in the right direction to be able to raise up that tide. Soccer coaches, the baseball coaches, men's basketball, we all want to be successful together. And we're all ambassadors of USC Upstate, not just necessarily our women's basketball program together. And it is my job as the head women's basketball coach to be able to instill and be able to create an opportunity for these young ladies to be able to walk across that stage and have a moral compass, to be able to have character, and to be able to sit across in an interview room and be able to give their conviction of who they are as people, to be able to navigate this world with a moral compass so that they can be able to go out there and be leaders in this world, not just followers, to be able to go out there and change this world as it is. And it is all of our jobs to be able to make sure that we're doing that consistently and building into these kids. What this program will look like. 20 years ago, as I was doing the math, I was like, when did I get out here in North Carolina? And I'm like, oh man, 20 years ago. 20 years ago, a young man with two duffel bags and a Honda Civic drove cross country. And I'm not kidding, no AC, drove cross country with me and my best friend. And in that drive, my parents, the people that have instilled in me, had three different things that were guiding me through this duration. It was character, it was work ethic, and it was the ability to be able to believe. Those three things is what our women's basketball program will be established upon. The ability to be able to have a character. We're gonna do what we say and say what we do. and we're going to constantly do that over and over and over again. We're going to have a relentless work ethic to be 1% better each and every day. Every single opportunity I can be able to get to, be able to walk into that gym or be able to go and meet somebody, I want to be able to pour into them consistently. That 1% better philosophy will get you to your goals. The last portion of it is the belief. Like, it's crazy to be able to think about 20 years ago, that young man, that boy in general, had the dream to be a collegiate head coach and to be able to go out there and be able to do it and impact individuals at a major, major stage. 20 years ago, two duffel bags, crazy to think about. And today, now I'm the head coach at USC Upstate. And that young man is going to be able to instill those characteristics within his team. It is my job and my staff's job to be a conduit. Our job is to be a conduit for these young ladies to be able to go out there and be able to do those three things. To be able to believe and dream big. And dream extremely, extremely big. To be able to go out there and work their tails off in and out of the classroom and in the community in general. To be able to take that 1% better and do it over and over and over again, no matter what people are saying about themselves. And to be able to have that character. To be able to go out there and to be able to, when the lights are off and nobody's watching, to do what they say and say what they do. Those are the individuals and the young ladies that we are going to be able to have in this program and that we are going to be able to mold. Our staff will be able to then be able to produce and be able to guide young ladies so that they have those three characteristics and instill in them consistently. And I am living proof that if you dream big, that you have the character, and that at the end of the day that you have the work ethic, you can be able to achieve absolutely anything. And I'm really, really excited to be able to have that opportunity to be able to help our kids be able to get to that point. I'm really, really excited and blessed to be the next head coach here at USC Upstate. Thank you very much for all of your time.
If you have any questions, I will entertain those, and if not, we'll ask those of you that want to meet Jason here off to the side, or actually, you can take it back.
Any questions?
How long will you give yourself before you think the team will achieve the Big South Conference championship?
Ooh, boy. She came right out. No time. You know, it takes time to be successful. You know, you don't change a ship overnight in terms of the direction. And so, but for us, like, we want to be able to go out there and compete for Big South championships literally day one. You know, but it starts with, like I talked about earlier, good character kids, because you can't win championships without character. Because when it get the tough times get there, you have to have kids that are willing to be able to buy into something bigger than themselves. And that character aspect of it will shine in our program consistently. And I'm really, really looking forward to being able to go out there and compete for championships right out the gate and in year one. Great first question. Appreciate you. Any other questions? Don't be bashful.
What's the number one key to success for the last 9 years of Belmont
Academy? Man, key to success for us has been the individual attention to our kids. It's to be able to pour into our kids as people in general first and foremost, and then be able to care about them secondly as basketball players or as student athletes. To be able to get in a relationship with our kids so that they know who we are and what we are looking for, and then to be able to then push them towards their dreams. The opportunity to be able to break down the walls and barriers of the ability to be able to achieve and shoot for a high goal. And so for us, like, pouring into kids consistently has been our secret sauce to success.
How do you plan to get your kids to buy into the belief that you're selling for the new program?
Ooh, good question. Good question. I think it's done with time. The more time that we can then be able to have with our kids on an individual basis in terms of we call it family time, or opportunities in the gym, like it will be able to get them to be able to buy into it. If you can't tell, I'm really, really passionate about what I do, and like the opportunity to be able to go out there and coach basketball at the collegiate level is a blessing, 110%. And so they're gonna see the passion within me and my staff on a regular basis, and that is infectious consistently. That will be able to trickle down from the assistant coaches to the players to the managers, all the way down into administration.
So part of what we got to continue to do is build our fan base, our support in the community. What are some ideas you have for doing that with outreach?
Oh, the outreach to the community is going to be big, and it goes in a lot of different avenues in terms of the kids in general, reading to middle schools, and being able to create a reading program, to be able to have a student night here in the facility. Different opportunities for us to be able to put our kids out there into the community so that they have to be role models. For us is going to be very, very big. I'm a firm believer that the more opportunities we can put our kids in the position to be role models, the more that they're going to be able to be successful individuals long after they graduate.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Related to Dr. Harris's question, what will you do to bolster fan support of women's basketball? As because you know, it's no secret from last year's NCAA tournament with the weight rooms, right? Mm-hmm. There's a big discrepancy. So, what do you do to make these women feel that they are just as valued in the sports world as their male counterparts?
That's a really good question.
It's an important one.
100%, you know, is to be able to give them equal time. You know, I think that the time aspect of it, and to be able to make sure that they know that they are valued as a high commodity, that what we're putting out there on the court is going to be a product that people want to be able to see consistently. You know, and I've seen some film of the stands being packed here at women's basketball games in general. And the more opportunities that we can be able to put people in the stands to be able to witness what we are looking at, consistently, that they will then know that like this is a good product, and this is as competitive as the men's program in general. And the more opportunities that we can be in the community consistently so that they know who they are watching in general and creating those relationships, they'll know the product on the court is going to be very, very good.
Chemistry is very important when it comes to a team. What are your first steps in building that with your new team?
Building chemistry, boy. Building chemistry with a team in general is a interesting mixture, to say the least. And then for us, it's about setting that culture from day one and knowing what they're getting from a Coach Williams-led team. To be able to know that like that Coach Williams cares about them and loves them consistently, but then also knowing that the fact that we are going to be doing things other than just the basketball aspect of it. We're going to work extremely hard on that basketball court, but then we're also then going to be able to put them in positions to be able to get to know each other, to be able to put down their cell phones a little bit and be able to have dialogue one-on-one consistently so that they can have the opportunity to be able to get to know each other. You know, and to be able to sit so that they're not sitting there at dinner a little bit and just on their phones consistently. They have the opportunity to be able to break down walls and be able to have conversations with people that look different than them, that speak different than them, and that are from different backgrounds. And that's what student athletes is all about, and that's what college is all about.
So I know you have to be excited to be able to recruit at this level, that to be one of them. So talk to us about how you build a team, both from the high school and the transfer.
Ooh, the transfer portal, that's a hot topic right there. I don't know if you have time to develop. it's an interesting mix because you want kids to be a part of this program for a duration. I'm a big Malcolm Gladwell person in terms of 10,000 hours to get to mastery. And so for me, in a Jason Williams program, like it takes time to be able to get towards the mastery in general. So I want kids that want to be here and want to be here for four straight years, three straight years in general. You know what I mean? But yes, you do need to be able to go and recruit the transfer portal enough to be able to go and get you an influx of maturity so that we have a product on the floor that's going to be representative of championships that everybody wants to go and watch, right? To kind of go from there. So it's an interesting dynamic to be able to mix the two together of just enough portal to be able to get your culture and the basketball right, but then enough of the younger kids to be able to make sure that they're in our program for the duration. Because once you are here, you want to be able to stay here because of the people that love them consistently. And then we're going to be building into a culture that's going to be cultivated around that care and that love and that ability to be able to go and win games. And winning cures a lot of different ailments in general. And so it's a mixture of the two. And I'm really, really excited. We're in the mix right now in terms of recruiting. Literally, my phone's probably blowing up as we speak to be able to get some kids on campus and be able to establish a championship program right out the gate. All good questions.
In your discovery process, what has been some of the good things you've learned about USC Upstate that's making you happy?
I'm going to keep saying it. It's the people. 110%. It is absolutely the people that are here that make this institution phenomenal. And the people that are here love to be able to service the student athlete. You know, and it's not necessarily, and it's to be able to make them better individuals so that they can be able to go out there and be stewards of the world and leaders of the world. And I felt that the moment I came here on campus. And that ability is what attracted me to this institution. And to be with like-minded people that want to do that, you have the opportunity to be able to grow in the right direction and success will happen. Yes, ma'am.
That's not really a question. I just want to say thank you for following your faith to become a counselor and a coach. Because I know student athletes face pressures and challenges at a higher level than the average person. And I think it's going to be very valuable that you're here to nurture
Thank you very much. Yeah, the counseling background, boy, I tell people all day, all the time, like, I might not be getting paid for it, but it's useful every single day. When they come into the office, they're sitting down on that couch in general, I'm like, man, what? I should be billing your insurance right now. But it's all good, you know? And so, like, it comes into handy on a consistent basis, and I'm very blessed. And I wanted to be able to work with kids, and I wanted to be able to help kids in general, and it just so happens that I get to spend more time with them in the basketball head coaching role than I do as a counselor. And so the impact is just different. And their parents entrust me with them in general, and it's my job to be able to exceed what the parents put into them in the beginning and throughout the learning process. So I'm beyond excited to continue that here at USC Upstate. Any counseling sessions for the adults? I don't do adults. Thank you very much. I look forward to working with absolutely everyone.